This almost invisible migration is being revealed by Stanford University's world-renowned scientist, Dr. Barbara Block.
Here we are flying above the Monterey Bay National Marine Sanctuary. Spectacular view today, and we've been studying this region for some time, and what we've learned from the tagging is that the largest migration on Earth occurs beneath the sea here.
The California Current is a river within an ocean. Each spring, it generates an explosion of life. North winds force warm surface waters to the west. Cold nutrient waters push up to fill the void. Plankton blooms feed vast schools of anchovies and sardines. They become fuel for predators. Blue and humpback whales arrive first. Elephant seals swim thousands of miles from North Pacific and subpolar seas to breed and molt. They haul out beside even larger colonies of sea lions. These pinnipeds draw the white sharks. Fewer than 300 white sharks swim to California from two mysterious offshore habitats. The waters surrounding Hawaii and an unexplored wilderness, the subtropical gyre nicknamed the White Shark Cafe. The sharks are bound for three National Marine Sanctuaries, all within 50 miles of San Francisco. Cordell Bank, the Greater Farallones, and Monterey Bay. Just off California's Año Nuevo Island, a science team is trying to turn white sharks into filmmakers. It's part of the world's longest white shark study. For Barbara Block, it all started in Woods Hole, Massachusetts.
In our white shark program, we're keeping alive a tradition of tagging that goes back almost 40 years now to when I was a young student working with Dr. Francis Carey, Frank Carey, of Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution.
Dr. Carey was pioneering deployment of acoustic technology on large predatory fish when a crisis struck the shark world.
Something going on. What's going on?
It was 1975, and the world's first summer blockbuster was released. Jaws smashed box office records and unleashed in irrational terror the idea that the only good shark was a dead shark. Jaws' author, Peter Benchley, was horrified and became a dedicated shark conservationist. He joined forces with Carey on the first scientific expedition to study white sharks in the Atlantic.
This will give us water temperature, the depth of the fish, and his muscle temperature.
He's coming up to the boat. He wants to bite the boat.
Dr. Carey believed white sharks' hunting ability, endurance, and intense bursts of speed were enhanced by being warm-bodied.
Nice place?
Nice place. Terrific. Let's see what his temperature is. It's 23.2. Water is 17 degrees, so the fish is 23. That's a 6-degree difference. That's really warm.
This important revelation was followed by a stream of scientific firsts, including Stan Waterman shooting this first footage of a white shark below American waters. Carey collected biological data as the shark swam for 110 miles over 5 days, showing that electronic tagging was the wave of the future. Barbara Block was Frank's technician. She was inspired and took Carey's pioneering science into the future.
Some 40 years later, with some of the world's most advanced technology that you can put on an animal in the sea, and what we're hoping to get is a lot more of the undersea behavior, what's really happening from the white shark point of view this year.
There are hot spots in the ocean that develop, in particular in places where the cold water that is upwelled meets the warm offshore water. And there is a plethora of animals that aggregate and create these very incredible hotspots. And they're very difficult to study, and it requires an ability to use autonomous vehicles to find them, and then use that information to go sample them with ships or other devices.
It's a laser focus on what makes Anyo such a powerful wildlife magnet.
So we're using these vehicles to first find the hot spots, but then float with them. Start with upwelling water with these new nutrients, and now we've got phytoplankton that bloom there, and then we've got zooplankton, bigger animals, fish, foraging fish, all the way up to these top predators, the whales that are eating them.
The team determined that the secret to Anyo is the two underwater canyons that channel nutrient-rich water toward the island. Sea lions go there every day to forage. The white sharks wait to ambush. The team spots bird activity. A shark has bitten a sea lion.
Just watch, keep an eye out for birds as we drift through here. And then it happens to pop back up.
Big seals and sea lions fight back, so sharks have learned to bite and get clear. He circles while the sea lion bleeds out.
Sharks, usually they come up to the carcass and they'll grab it and they'll take it down and they'll swim away. So they don't have hands like we do to hold it while they bite. So they use the friction of the water as they're swimming to hold the carcass while they shake their head.
A lion of the blue Serengeti.